emotions are? Feelings, okay. What else?
Attachment.
So what emotion do you go through because of attachment? We are just coming to why are we talking about anger. So emotion, you said feelings, you said attachment. What else?
Thoughts.
So thoughts also make you feel some emotion. That's what you're saying, right? Anyone else would like to have some input on this? Okay, very good. Response to people and situations, right? So these are all ways and means by which we understand emotion. Emotion is a response to a particular situation or a person. It is a feeling towards a person, for a person, or with a person. It is an emotion that you go through because of attachments with people. Right? So understanding this, when we say we are trying to balance emotion, and what are we talking about is anger. So I would like y'all to give me an input as to what is anger according to y'all. We'll read out the slide surely, but according to y'all, what is anger? It's a state of mind. Thank you, sir. It's a very nice answer you give this. Okay, agitated state of mind. It's an addition to state of mind which we are talking about. Pardon? Dissatisfaction. So when we are agitated or when we are dissatisfied with a particular situation or a person, that is when we get angry. That is the emotion which we go through. That is anger. So when we talk about anger, somewhere there is an expectation which is not fulfilled. Am I correct? And that is why we are agitated or dissatisfied. And then again comes to serve with what you spoke about attachment. When we are attached to someone, we have an expectation. When we have an expectation, that is why we have a dissatisfaction. All three are connected, right? So now we'll see how to go about and understand this. I'll just read out what anger is as per the definition. It is an emotional reaction characterized by extreme displeasure, as we talked about dissatisfaction, rage, agitation we spoke about, indignation or hostility. When someone is bad towards us, we get angry, right? So that's what we spoke about right now. It is considered to be pathological origin when such a response does not realistically reflect a person's actual circumstances. Just as someone said, when we are not satisfied with the circumstance or the situation, that is when we get angry, right? However, expression of anger vary widely in different individuals and cultures and may be considered functional under certain controlled circumstances. Now, this we are going a little more further. It's okay. As we got it from you itself, the group itself, what is anger? So when I read out, you must have noticed that whatever the group said is there in the definition. Right? Now the further what it is saying, it is expression of anger is widely different with different individuals. Right? So do you all agree to this statement?
Yeah.
Right? So that is the reason why we need to speak about anger. Okay? So in this entire time which we are going to spend with you all, we will be speaking about all these aspects as to how different individuals react in different situations and different people. Okay? Now there are certain elements which come up in anger. As we spoke about dissatisfaction, as we spoke about, now how do we react to that dissatisfaction? What is the first thing that comes to our mind?
Dislike.
So somewhere we are not happy with the opposite person, right? What else? Behavior also changes, right? Towards the person, towards the circumstance, everything changes. Body language changes. What else? Okay, as we said that you said dislike, And someone said that behavior changes, right? So that's how we start with the first element of anger. That is, we start blaming. Don't we? You are wrong. The first thing is, how could you do this to me? Have you all experienced this? When you're angry, the first thought is what? How could you all do this to me? Right? So somehow we start blaming instead of looking at any other angle of the particular incident or circumstance. So once we start blaming, it's a circle. It's very difficult to come out of that circle once we get into that circle. So I'm sure all of you all would have experienced this circle. We will give some time for giving your experiences also, so that it becomes interactive rather than just me speaking. So what we saw is there is a blame game involved. Then what we see is there is a cycle of anger and resentment. As I said, when we get into this, it's a cycle. We blame, they blame. It's a continuous process, right? If I tell you, you are wrong, it's natural that for human being to say that, no, you are wrong. And we always find reasons why other person is wrong. It's human behavior. They may be wrong, I'm not denying that they might not be wrong, but somehow if we do not get into the blame and deal with the circumstance, it becomes easier to come out of the cycle. That is what we are going to see further. Now, anger, there are certain things which we need to see that it is good when reason controls anger. What do you understand by this statement? It is good when reason controls anger.
You have reason to be angry.
Okay. Right?
It's not bad to be angry.
It's not bad to be angry. Right?
It's not negative emotion.
No. So, when you say reason should control your anger, it just means that if you are angry also, we should reason ourselves. Is it right for us to express our anger right now? We should reason ourselves, is it right that we are getting angry at this point, or is there something else that is bothering us and that is why we are getting angry? Or else, that is it that this particular point or particular topic is making me aggressive? In general, it is nothing to be get angry about. There are certain things which you individually feel angry. Now, there is a simple example. An auto rickshaw driver says no to go somewhere. What happens to us? Little angry. Agitated. Exactly. Now, can we reason that maybe there is some reason why he is saying that I don't want to go? What is there in our mind is all the auto rickshaw wala will say no to us. That's got installed in our mind. So that is why we react rather than we respond. These are the small things wherein we are coming to. We should allow reason to control anger rather than anger to control the reason. There could be a reason why that auto rickshaw driver said no to us, but our control is not over that. Our control is getting angry. I am getting angry because he said no to me. So
response is always controlled and reaction
is always uncontrolled. You're right, sir. I hope everyone agrees with that. What he said is response is always controlled. Okay. Now, when there is any circumstance, as I said, this example. Okay. Now, what would be the reaction?
Irritated
and getting angry at him. No, you have to go. It is a rule, and you have to means you start fighting with that, right? Now, respond could be, see, I need to go urgently. I need to go urgently. If it is possible, please drop me. So this is a respond. Now there is a possibility that if you have responded, the auto rickshaw driver might take you. I'm not saying responding always gives you a positive reaction, but the possibility or probability increases, right? So we are seeing, we'll further see into this, the respond and react. But what we are going back to is, usually, as we said, anger comes out from violence. We behave in a violent way. When we are angry, we are always screaming. So these are the reasons why we need to control or balance anger. I wouldn't say control, I would say maintain anger. Okay? Now, how do y'all generally react when you are angry?
Shouting loudly.
Pardon?
Bad labeling. Using bad words.
Using bad words. What is?
Shouting. Raising voice.
Raising voice. Shouting.
Throwing whatever in hand.
Okay. Throwing whatever in hand. Extreme, but that happens. Very frequently it happens.
Blaming others.
It's somewhere like becoming sad and depressed. When you're not feeling good. Some people, rather than expressing their anger violently, they just get into themselves. The anger is reverse. So when you're sulking, it is just about getting inside yourself and not wanting to discuss it with anyone else. Sulking is becoming sad. Okay? Now, arrogance, yes, you become very arrogant when you're angry, right? You might even hurt the person whom you love the most. Have you all experienced this? Right? Though you might not want to hurt that person, though you would not want that to say bad words to that person, but when you're angry, you do not have that control. That is where again we come back to the same point. Let reason control anger rather than anger controlling the reason. Right? I understand. I understand. We are coming to that.
Break it up into components and stages.
Correct.
How reason can
control
over,
anger.
Overtake
anger. Yeah. We'll come to that. We'll come to that. We'll come to that.
Madam, you said voluntary or involuntary movements. Voluntary or involuntary movements.
What are you talking about, voluntary or involuntary?
Emotions. See the actions.
Yeah. Action. Action could be voluntary, could be involuntary. Actions cannot be defined as this is a, you cannot bifurcate it into voluntary or involuntary. It could be both depending upon the situation. Right? Now,
voluntary and reaction is involuntary.
How? It's not always necessary. Now, response also can be involuntary. Right? There are many responses which just happen. We are not volunteering to do that act or not volunteering to respond in a particular fashion. It just happens, right? We are not actually thinking or we are not taking up that action from within that, okay, I have to respond this way. It is our behavior. So sometimes it could be involuntary. Sometimes it could be voluntary. When I say voluntary, it means that we could choose to react or respond in a particular fashion depending upon the circumstances. Correct? Can we move further? Is this clear up till now?
Has there been any evidence to show that anger results in skin disorders?
Yes, there have been. There have been research done, but we have not bought up here because the time is less and we do not want to.
What does it mean, respiratory disorders?
Breathing.
Breathing. And that's
becoming. No, these are the effects of anger on our body. If you frequently get angry, these could be the effects in your body. Like, if you all have noticed, what are the bodily reactions to anger? Forget this. For a moment, just don't look at the slide. What? Yes. Breathing is fast. What else?
Blood pressure
rises. Pardon?
Shivering.
Shivering happens. Why? Because your body is not able to take that much of emotion into it. Right? What else? some people get so high, so that because of their muscle and the pressure, again that is related to pressure. When the pressure rises, the color of your face changes, right? Anything else? Have you noticed people sweating while they are angry? Right? And have you noticed voluntary reactions like biting their teeth? This is physical reactions to anger, right? So, no emotion. We are just talking about anger. But I would say there is no emotion which doesn't have an effect on our body. All emotions that we go through, whether for a second or a minute or an hour, has a reaction to our body. So anger is something which we experience very frequently. With today's kind of stress and today's kind of life which we are going through, so we are very, very susceptible to anger nowadays. So that is the thing which we have just put into. We have certain things which we go through: headaches, gastrointestinal disorders, respiratory, skin. All these things happen within our body which go unnoticed for a very long time. We will not notice it right now. Maybe we are getting angry, but are we noticing that we have a headache because of anger? Are we noticing that our breathing is going high? And if we are daily getting angry, even for 5 minutes, which we do normally because there are so many things happening with us, so that what effect that is having on our body, this is just to give you a picture of that, right? So these are certain things which happen when body is getting hurt because of anger. Now, does it affect only the body? Right? Emotional also, right? I would suggest don't look at the slide for a moment. Just talk about yourself. What is it that you all feel, other areas of anger that harm you all? We will read the slide, but I want you all to speak. How would you think that anger is affecting you without, except for the body aspect of this? Concentration, what else? You get more frustrated. What else?
More irritated.
Irritated.
You feel sorry also.
You feel sorry.
Rationality is sacrificed.
Pardon?
Rationality.
Rationalize. Okay. Rationalization is not proper. It's not possible, right? When you are angry.
Rationality is killed.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. What did you say, sir? Okay, so functionally, the daily work is not being done rightly. What else? Right? So, did you all ever think that anger affects us in so many ways?
Performance.
So, what have been your coping mechanisms to deal with anger? Pardon?
Stop and think before you react.
Nice.
Divert the mind.
Divert the mind.
Do some prayers.
Okay. What else?
So they say okay, you count 1, 2, 3, 4. And by that time your head is quiet.
Okay.
Listen to some good soothing music.
Music. So are you all using these coping mechanisms? Or they are just at the surface? Somehow what happens is, when you get angry, these coping mechanisms are lost.
Shut up.
At that time, you all don't think about it. We'll come to that. That's how I asked you before going to the slide. If not anger, if you are not getting angry, then what are we doing? Right? What to do about the anger? What do you all think? As you all said, fine, but if there is a person who knows that he gets angry very frequently, is there anyone who would volunteer to know that? Anyone who knows that that person gets very angry? You get very angry? Okay. So what have been the measures that you have taken for that?
You go for a walk.
Okay. So the moment you're angry, you walk out of the situation.
No, not the moment I'm angry. Whatever process will release at that time,
So already that is said.
Yeah,
so the reaction is done. After the damage. Okay. Now, what can you do before the damage? Do you realize that there is a damage done because of the anger?
If you are teaching this, it's very good for us to calm ourselves and not to get it. It's good for the health and everything, and not to disturb other people. You also do that?
Yes.
How do you do it?
I'll tell you all. I will give you all my experience.
Yeah.
But I would want to know the group first, so that I can give you all what I manage, how I manage my anger. Relation to relation.
Somewhere you are getting angry at the traffic police. Obviously, you don't walk away to release.
Exactly,
that.
Yeah.
But it depends situation.
But what my question is, have you felt that anger has done damage to relationships you don't want to damage?
Yes, sometimes it does.
Right?
Yes.
So, now how to manage that? That's where we are coming to. Okay? You said you go for a walk, but that is after the damage is done. So at the moment, what before that, what you can do? List down. Sit down and list down the possible triggers which you go through. Why do you get angry? The reasons when you get angry.
No, but like you tell your servant, one who's helping you everything. Tell him once, you tell him twice, you again he goes on doing what you do that.
Exactly. Now, what is the trigger? How would you term that trigger as?
Because when you tell him to clean this every day, when he doesn't do it, then what do
so
you do?
So, trigger is expectation?
Huh?
What is the trigger? The trigger is expectation, you are expecting.
Okay.
Yeah, but you are expecting, that is why you are getting angry.
But then you kiss him three or four times.
Yeah.
And still he goes on doing.
Agreed.
It naturally comes in.
Yeah.
Peace. Which I love you.
Actually, there's a state of mind that I'm not being accepted as accepted.
Huh.
You should do it.
Exactly. Expectation.
Yeah.
That is what our mind or our daily routine is demanding.
Okay.
I am expecting that my servant should do, yeah, should not repeat the mistake.
Oh, he forgets.
Fine, he forgets. But what is from your end? You are expecting your servant to do certain things in certain ways.
Yeah.
So the trigger is your expectation. For the anger, the trigger is your expectation, right?
It's a normal nerve thing.
I understand, ma'am, that we will come to how to deal with that. But we are trying to know what is the trigger. So what I'm asking you all to do is jot down the triggers. And if you go to see, the trigger will have a theme. Now what do I mean by theme? That means somewhere there would be certain things which would come in all the triggers. Like certain things would be expectation. Certain things would be discomfort. Certain things would be that I should not be late. I mean, the schedule should be as it should. Again, comes boils down to expectation. But what are the triggers is very important to know. Once you know the trigger, then you know how to deal with the reaction. I know I'm going to get angry on this. I'm sure. Right? So, how to respond rather than react to this? Now, as you know that you're going to get angry if the servant is not doing it the way it is. Right? So, what are the ways to remind him? Is there a way that you can remind him to do that? Can you stick a to-do list in his own language? Can you ask him to stick a to-do list? That you have to do this. Make a checklist. Before you move out of the house, after completing your work, this has to be done. This is just one example which came to my mind on spot. There could be ways to deal with that situation that makes you angry. Right? So until you do not know the trigger, you will not think about the possible solutions. Am I right? Do you all feel the same what I'm saying? Right?
Yeah, but I said maybe a month back I can hear really and like what you said, just the damage is there and you go out. And then later on probably you can write the triggers.
But now today if you go back home and write down the triggers.
Without any
trigger.
Very difficult to identify the triggers. Because triggers are partly external and partly internal.
I understand.
Both aspects have to be analyzed.
Correct.
And I think everybody feels helpless before anger. Because they can't analyze even one. What about analyzing both external and internal?
Can we just give ourselves quick 2 minutes to identify at least one trigger? Every one of you all, I'll give you all 1 minute and just identify one thing that triggers you to get angry. Take your time. When you're ready, just let me know.
But again, there will be different situation.
It's okay. We are just trying to see how you all can think on that trigger. Can you just think one trigger, everyone? And if someone has already thought about it, can voice it please?
Delays.
Pardon?
Delays.
Delays. Great.
Expectations.
Expectations.
What is that?
When someone is causing loss to himself or to me.
Expectation? Delays. Expectation.
Oh, expect it, but every time he does it, 4 or 5 times, and what do you do?
So, somewhere what we are boiling down to is, if we go to see,
Quietly.
Yeah.
You understand.
Yeah, I understood. Very clearly understood. That's what I understood what you're saying. But somewhere, if you see, you talk about delays. You talk about things getting on time. You talk about, you know, irritation or whatever you talk about boils down to. Expectation, one word, right? So this is where we are trying to understand, if we expect something, who is responsible for that expectation?
I.
Right? So this expectation, so responsible person is who? Right? So who will find the solution? So this is where we come to. Rather than again not getting into the cycle of blame, we are coming back to self. So now seeing, what am I expecting? Is my expectation rational or irrational? There are times when we have irrational expectations from certain relationships. Accepted? That this person should do everything for me on time at this particular, in this way. Not even in the way that opposite person will do. Maybe the person is doing it, but is not doing it the way you want that person to do. Happens? So list down the expectations with the people whom you are seeing that you are getting angry too much. possible solution I'm giving. Then maybe you can have a win-win communication with that person. That see, these are my expectations from you. Not that I am expecting because I want to expect, but this is the role which I feel you can play. Now what is it that you all can, you can do in this and you cannot? Let's discuss. Exactly. Exactly. When am I saying do this exercise? Not when you're angry. Before the trigger. What have we done this workshop for? That henceforth, we people who are here, try and not become victim of anger. I'm not saying it will not happen. It might just reduce in times, the number. We are humans, we are emotional beings, and we will go through emotions. What we can control is only one thing, that how do we manage these emotions. This will not eradicate. Out of the blue, you will not become a person who will never get angry, and you don't need to be. Anger is a healthy emotion also. Anger helps in building yourself also. If you have never got angry on yourself, will you have improved?
Never tried.
You would have never tried. You would have never improved, right? If there would have been no anger because of the rape which happened in Delhi, what would have happened? But still it is happening, but still people are angry. Can we eradicate that anger? No. It is the response that can be maintained and managed. Correct? Are we at one level? Does that answer your question, ma'am?
You have to explain how to manage expectations.
Exactly.
But that is the root cause of all things.
Manage expectation is, as I said, jot down the expectations from every person around you. And please communicate. Maybe that person is not aware that you are expecting that much from that person. Maybe that person is like not even aware that we can talk. Maybe that person is as angry as you are because you are always angry with that person. Or the opposite person might be feeling the same for you. Please, it is just about communicating that expectation. We are talking about, if we are communicating that expectation, we can at least balance that expectation. We can weigh that, are we rationally expecting or irrationally expecting? Is that person, you know, has that capacity to expect that much or not? Are we expecting from the right person or not? Is he capable of doing whatever you are asking him to do? If he is capable, he is forgetting. So do you feel that you are in some situation or some position to help him manage that? Can you put down the list? Can you ask him to put down the list? What are the other ways? Okay, you forget. So let me ask you, what can I do for you? Can I just remind you, the moment you come, you will not get annoyed at me if I remind you? Because people get annoyed at reminders also. So a win-win talk. That if I tell you, whenever you come in, I will just repeat that you have to do this, 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 this. And we will do the checklist before going. Solves the situation? Make it a habit to have a checklist.
Habit of forgetting.
Habit of a checklist.
Not doing it.
Habit of a checklist before going out of the house. Have you done this, 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 this is done?
Yeah.
So that has solved that situation. You will not get angry because he's not done it, because there is a checklist. So are we looking at solutions or are we looking at problems? Generally what happens, we look at problems. we are looking at that, we are getting angry and that person is not listening. Is it our responsibility to make that person listen, or is it his responsibility to understand that, okay, we can? Somewhere there are times when the situation is out of our control, as the rape example, that is not in our control. But then what can we do? Can we just feel angry and not do anything? We can at least see to it that nothing wrong is happening around us, right? So what are the healthy modes? That's all we can discuss. So what we discussed is identify your triggers. Recognize signs that you're becoming angry. Fine, once you identified, but then to how do you manage, as sir said, that we need expert to tell us how you will recognize. How would you recognize that you're getting angry? What happens to you first? What is your first body reaction when you're angry? Every person has an individual body reaction, right? So identify that. Because before you verbalize your anger, your body starts reacting, which goes unseen by you today.
At some places, there are conditions beyond that. Like, I may be angry for the climate.
Uncontrollable things, yes. Right? So what can you do for the climate?
If my servant is not doing anything, I'll get up and I'll do myself.
I'm saying, what can you do for the climate?
For the climate, what you can do? Like,
what can you do?
Or
you adjust to it. Accept it. Things which we cannot change, we accept. And we ask God that give us the sense to identify from the two. Right? It's a serenity prayer. If you get to read it, please read it. It helps a lot. It says, if the meaning of that prayer is, there are certain situations that you can change, please change, and there are certain situations that you cannot change. So please learn to accept them and find the best out of them, and ask God that He will help you to identify both of them. So that's how it goes, the serenity prayer. So, I do not remember the words, but the meaning I just spoke out. It means that identify what you can change and accept what you cannot change.
And wisdom to know the difference.
Wisdom to know the difference. Grant me the wisdom to know the difference between the two. Yeah? If you just do go to Google and type serenity prayer, you will get it. Yeah? Yeah. So learn to respond to frustration and anger in a controlled, healthy way. Now the third point says learn to respond to the frustration and anger in a controlled, healthy way. What harms? A controlled anger? Does it harm? Ever has controlled anger done any harm? How? No, controlled anger means analyzed, or when it is a respond, when you are responding to a particular situation, when you are assertively saying something to someone. So does that harm?
It harms.
How?
See, when you are undergoing the process itself is painful. You are dealing with something very negative. You are trying to overcome itself. That requires a lot of energy to gain it. Then the whole system will be exercised in a very negative way. That is how it happens.
Give me an example.
Love is lacking. I am angry. My reason says, okay, fine, she has done that thing, but I have to control myself.
Am I saying not to respond? I'm saying a controlled respond, not react.
Why controlled response is required at all? It is required because something negative has happened.
Exactly. Now, if as you said, the example, right? In this example, if someone is slapping you, how would you react and how would you respond?
Irrational and rational both ways.
And if you just assertively say that, sir, what you did was wrong, and I would not take this type of behavior henceforth, what does it explain? Is this a response or a?
It's a response, all right.
It's a response.
But creating a rational response is also a negative process going on in the mind.
In your mind, that okay, I'm hurt because he slapped me, right?
The damage already started long back.
For you, the damage is started. But how can you resolve that damage?
Reasoning, rationality, intellect.
Can you heal that feeling?
I can reduce that damage.
Yeah.
Healing, 100% healing is not possible.
100% healing is not possible. According to you, no, it's fine. 100% healing is not possible, fine. But it will at least reduce the density of the feeling.
Definitely.
Yeah? So if you react, what will happen? Increase?
Multiplying.
That is what we are talking about. So what we are talking about is? Pardon?
The person who is slapping.
Exactly. And it could lead to a fight. This is, don't we think this has been happening with India-Pakistan?
Now it is happening everywhere on the road.
Yeah, exactly. Because there is very low level of acceptance. Resistance level is very low. Tolerance is not there. So exploring underlying feelings such as sadness or depression. Have you realized that if you are sad, you feel very more angry? Right? Already if you have had a bad day and someone comes and tells you something, don't you get more irritated than what you would normally be? So just being aware of that sadness. Just being aware that I'm sad and I might get angry. That helps. Sometimes just being aware helps. You know that you're going home. You know that there might be some questions. There might be someone who is waiting and is going to ask something, and already you are depressed or sad. So what would help you? I'm aware that I'm in this mood, so I would not react to the situation in the office or home, whatever. I would respond. If you have that awareness with you, you might avoid the anger, right? So this is how we are learning to avoid the anger. So what did we say? That accepting that responsibility is mine, being aware, right? Okay, then we go to people use a variety of both conscious and unconscious processes to deal with their angry feeling. Do you all agree to this?
Yeah.
Right? Unconsciously you suppress anger. Unconsciously you have that, okay, just forget it. I don't want to think about it. Consciously you feel that, no, I want to resolve this. I want to revenge. I want to deal with this. Some people never speak about that they got angry. Right? So there are different reactions with different people. How do people actually deal with anger? As we just spoke about, some people express, some people suppress, some people try calming themselves down. Have you all experienced all these different things at different times? And it also happens with different relationships. Right? For example, maybe with a subordinate you will get angry, but maybe with a boss you will suppress. It's natural. As in home front, with children you might suppress, with spouse you might be expressing, right? And with someone else you would just calm yourself down, just forget it. So it differs at different time and individual how they take up, which way to express, which way to suppress is different. Anything on this? Anything you all would like to ask on this? Right? But one thing is very important which we need to see is, we need to express our anger But how do we need to express? We need to express it assertively. The problem comes when we become violent, and when we are not assertive, we are aggressive.
Can we have an example of how to be assertive?
Yes.
Okay. Can we have a role play? A 1 minute role play?
Yes.
Any two people volunteer? Just 2 minutes, come on. Yeah. Say something which where anger could be there, anger could come up with.
It is not civilized to wear very dark colors in an important meeting like this. Why do you not come in a very light color? I don't like this color at all.
How would you express it?
It's my way of dressing, it's my sense of dressing.
Respond or react?
What was that? What did you feel was it?
What he said is like assertive.
He said was assertive or aggressive, the group?
Aggressive. Could have been aggressive, but he didn't portray it.
Portrayed, but the statement was aggressive.
Yes.
What he said was? And what he said was?
My way of dressing.
He probably thought that he should calm himself down because it doesn't.
He calmed himself down rather than becoming aggressive, but he was not assertive. He expressed, yeah, but it was a flat expression. Now, if I would have expressed it, I would have been, sir, I think we are free to dress the way we want to, and this had no formal decorum, so I came the way I wish to come. Is this assertive? Right? Did you all get that point, or do you all really want some more examples on this? Right? Assertive is when you are not actually jumping onto someone but expressing your view. Aggressive is when you start jumping. How could you say this? It's my wish. Whatever I do is my wish. Correct. Uh-huh. But then assertive, yeah. So that's the way we can manage assertive and aggressive. What happens when you're not expressing your anger?
Repressing.
Repressing. What happens then? If you don't express for months, years, you don't express. Feel sick. Body starts reacting.
Emotional
bouts, right? You get angry, then you start getting angry on anything and anywhere, there is no reason, right? Then the reason is not there. The anger is controlling the reason is not controlling the anger. So that's what happens when you are not expressing the anger. This commonly happens, I'm not saying it doesn't happen with men, but this commonly happens with women in India. Suppress, 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 and then suddenly it is like, then they say that girl, that lady has started getting too angry and she needs to meet some doctor or something. Commonly happens that way. Now, there are a lot of other emotions which men do not express, that's different. So that's how we come down to, there are a lot of things which happen when you're not expressing your anger. Now, why some people get more angry than others?
There's various threshold levels of tolerance.
Okay. Threshold levels of tolerance. What else? Pardon? Egoistic people.
I am better than others.
Yeah. Ego. What else?
Tolerance isn't there with
it. Tolerance, as we said, very low threshold of tolerance. Ego. One point we just spoke about.
Not flexible,
okay. Adamant, can we say that? Right? People who are adamant. Then just now we spoke about people who have suppressed a lot of anger, who have already had, the rim is overboard. So that's when people start getting angry, right? It's just like, now how much can you hold in your hand? If I try to hold this, I try to hold this, I try to hold something else also, won't it start falling? So it's as good as that. Now I have very few things in hand, but if you have more than this, can you catch it? It will just spill, right? That's what happens to your anger or any emotions, I would say. On any emotion, what happens is, until you have not expressed it in a right way, right balance, it starts falling out in wrong ways or not accepted ways, I would say. So now, as it says, what makes these people this way? Now, what we said was socio-cultural effects, but there are certain people who have genetic or physiological reasons to do that. There are children who are born that way. It's their behavior, right? So there are certain times genetics also play a role in anger, okay? Now, one thing which we missed out was, anger has always given a negative tonation. You should not get angry. Gussa nahi hona chahiye. Suna hai aap log ne kabhi bhi? It is always that, don't get angry. Achhi baat nahi hai. Especially with girls.
Spoiling all the things.
In Indian culture, this happens a lot with girls and adolescent boys. Gussa mat hona. ठीक है कुछ भी हो जाए झगड़ा मत करके आना मारपीट मत करके आना दीज आर सर्टन थिंग्स विच वी कीप हियरिंग सो वॉट कम्स टू आर माइंड दैट वी शुड नॉट बी एक्सप्रेसिंग एंगर राइट बट इज इट दैट वे आफ्टर वॉट वी हैव स्पोकन टिल नाउ डू यू ऑल थिंक इट इज राइट नॉट टू एक्सप्रेस एंगर बट इन अ हेल्दी वे Right? And we spoke about healthy ways to express anger. Correct? And effects of anger on health, as we already spoke about, it's elevated heart rate, blood pressure, chest pains, bone density decreases, immune system reduces. So all these things happen. If a person is very angry, it also affects the metabolism. If you're angry, certain people get very hungry, certain people get I don't want to eat anything, I'm very angry. So these all things are part of the things which happen to your health when you're angry.
Can any of these effects be reversed when you're angry?
Pardon?
Can any of these effects be
reversed
when you're angry?
Like the damage is done.
Huh.
But now you start
accept. Yeah, it does. It does. It does.
Like something like a decrease in bone density. Do you think it can be reversed when you're angry?
What aspect are you talking about? I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Like, one effect of anger is a decrease in bone density.
Bone density.
With time, if you learn to control your anger, do you think
at least it will not do more harm, and the medicines that you're taking would give you a better effect on that.
You have to do two things. One is to control your anger in a rational way, and the second is to stand in sunlight, morning sunlight.
So it is about balancing again.
Yeah.
So now at least it would be damage done can be controlled in a lot of other aspects, but bone density is something which now there is a lot of things like breathing.
Yeah.
If it has damaged your breathing, with breathing exercises you can normalize things, right? If you're talking about heart, how much it has affected your heart. If you control it, if you balance it, and if you maintain your anger in a healthy form and have proper exercises like breathing exercise plus your yoga or anything, it can come back. But if you are continuing with the anger the way you have been dealing with anger, then even medicines will not affect. because that's a process which is ongoing. So that's the reason why we, as we have already spoken about this, we've just put it in a slide, that anger always is not bad. We need to express our anger. It is not possible that we do not go through this emotion, right? And all of us go through this emotion, and it is not always bad. It is just how you express it matters rather than going through that emotion. Okay?
You don't take others' anger lying down.
Hmm. Don't keep it to yourself, one, and don't express it in a way where it will harm others or even harm yourself, right? So what is the key which can do work is manage. You cannot stop, or you cannot say that you will not get angry, or you cannot say that there would be no circumstances in life that you need to get angry. You cannot expect an ideal form of life, but what you can do is manage this anger. And I think in this entire period we have spoken about managing, how to manage your anger. These are certain tips which we must have gone through all the time. Take time out. Once you're calm, express your anger. Once you're calm, sir, not before you're calm. Get some exercise. Think before you speak. Then identify possible solutions, as we spoke about, ma'am. Identify what are the solutions you can make for that circumstance to change, that you can do. Stick with I statements. We spoke about responsibility, me. So I am responsible for this situation. I can change it. How I can do it, how I can manage things, how I can be on time, how I cannot get delayed. These would help, right? Then do not hold grudge. Trying to not carry on. Just as I said, if I had a book of first standard, if I would carry chalks, if I would carry pencils, if I would carry my water bottle all throughout my life, would I be able to walk? So what we need to do is, we felt angry, we expressed our anger, we need to drop it. It's difficult, it will be a process, it will not happen in a day. But at least this self-talk that we need to drop it is important. Yeah? Use humor to release tension. Very simple to understand. Practice relaxation skills. Know when to seek help. Now if you're getting angry at every drop of a pin, that means you need to seek help. So you need to know when you need to go to a professional for help. Getting angry is normal, but as you feel that, okay, you're, as someone said, throwing things. So if you're actually throwing things at small matters, please seek help. Then relaxation skills, everyone has different aspects which they feel relaxed. Some people would like to go for a walk, some people would like to listen to music, some people would like to do yoga, breathing, etc., etc., etc. Next, I think she'll continue. It's about our company, where we come from. She's my colleague, Megha.
As you rightly discussed, how its impact on our health and at an emotional level.
एंगर इज वन इमोशन, बट ऐसे बहुत सारे इमोशन से हम रोज गुजरते हैं और तभी हमें फील होता है कि कभी कभी ऐसा लगता है कि प्रोफेशनल हेल्प लेनी चाहिए, या कभी कभी लगता है किसी और से बात करना है. मतलब मैं जिसको जानती हूँ उससे नहीं, मुझे किसी और थर्ड पर्सन से बात करना है जो मेरे बारे में नहीं जानता है. एंड आई नीड सम गाइडेंस, आई नीड सम इन्फॉर्मेशन. सो यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट अस. इट्स आई कॉल, इट्स इनिशिएटेड बाय टाटा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ सोशल साइंसेज. इट्स अ साइको सोशल एंड लीगल हेल्पलाइन. सो वी ऑफर टेलीफोनिक काउंसलिंग एंड इट्स ओपन. Yeah, it's a counseling. So there are trained professionals and we maintain confidentiality and anonymity. So there's no need to worry that information will leak. And it's open on Monday to Saturday 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. and it's also open on bank holidays. And if you have any queries, you can always email icall@tiss.edu.